Well, hi. Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Cyberpunk 2077 Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. We're headed towards a hard or high danger thingy here. And after that, we're going to head down to a side job here. Finish this reported crime. Welcome to Night City. And then we're going to the Ripper Dock. So, there's a little peninsula here. It's pretty interesting. So, figure we'll do this stuff on the way. This guy's taking up the whole sidewalk. What does the star mean? A hooligan. Does that mean he's wanted or something? I guess. The end is near.
What the gnee?
Peekaboo! I thought he threw a grenade or something. Yeah, what do stars mean? Well, I see him a bit peckish here, so I'll have the very racist sounding Mr. Whitey. I don't know what it is. An energy bar? A burrito? I couldn't say. Worn biker shorties. It looks pretty final. Well, that guy disappeared. What's up? So this wasn't it, obviously. This the star means these people were wanted or something? Is this that the guy I killed? Oh yeah, it was a lighter? Could be right. I was like, what was he shooting me with? He was shooting me with the overture. So how much further is this thing? It's pretty close. So otherwise I'd grab that van. So I'm gonna not grab the van. I'm gonna jump over people.
Hey, ten cuidado.
Oh, cuidado. I can't jump over you. I tried. Oops. My bad. So let's see if this really is as dangerous as I thought. Well, Capitan Reyes.
Hey, how
How's life in NC? Getting any sleep?
Not lately.
I'm not. Not when there's money to be made.
Okay.
So listen, one of my people, name's Juliet, was supposed to deliver me some precious data. Never made it. Getting total radio silence. Check on her, will you? And don't forget the data. Specs attached.
Okay. Search and recover. Retrieve the Zeta Tech data. Juliet Horrigan owes El Capitan. House on Gibson Street. I like everyone to know I'm patient, understanding. I realize there's a time for work and a time for family. Without a good work-life balance, we'd all blast our brains out. I get it. I do. But disappearing for 2 weeks because of family issues? That's how Juliet thinks of me? How much she respects me? I love her because she ripped so much Nova data out of Zeta Tech for me, but man, she's starting to hurt my feelings, you know? Go to her place, see what her deal is, but remember, number one priority is that data she still owes me. Juliet's Nova and all, but if she's got a problem with that, well, like I said, data is prio number one. Okay. Really just march into the front door? Should we check another way? Force it open? Can't. No can do. Can't mess with it either. Can I climb up there? Oh! Can't grab the ladder, huh? Well, awfully limiting. Can't climb up. At least not that I can see. Well, through the front door we go. Oh, really? My technical ability isn't even that great. With these grates, these windows. I'm trying to find a way in. Here we go. If you don't succeed, try again. Oh. I'm in. Oops. not that stealthy, am I?
What a mess. Reeks, too. Usual hallmarks of a merc's room stop there.
First aid kit.
Almost completely used up. Not something you'd keep in your medicine cabinet.
I heard something else slide just then. Expletive deleted. Dried blood.
Oh, shit!
Someone took a nasty hit on this.
Signs of a struggle?
Well, that, yeah.
To put it mildly.
I did just pick up some euros. There's more euros. Can't get it. There's some activity. I hear sliding doors. Some euros again. Saving because I'm going to do a scan. Well, he's gone. Wish I could get the other euros. Well, it's, I'm like, is the computer smoking? Hey! From Rose Horrigan to Juliet Horrigan. Julie! OMG, it's been ages. How's life? Guess I'm writing with something on my mind. Remember when we were kids, we played on that old dam? We'd shout our names, some other stupid stuff, then listen for the echoes. How our voices carried through the valley. Sometimes I still feel like I can hear them. Different, strange words, like returning from a long trip out of town. Funny, right? I don't know, Julie. The truth is, everything's going off the rails. I feel worse and worse. Losing my job certainly didn't help, and what the hell good was that new cyberware for, huh? Ugh. I hope I'm not scaring you or asking too much, but I was just thinking how nice it'd be to hear your voice, not just some echo of it. Maybe that's what I need to get right again? Rose. From Juliet to Rose. Rosie! Of course I remember the dam. Even the time we tried to kick that gonk Benny Dillard and his drone off of it. And yeah, I did hear about your job. I'm really sorry, that sucks so hard. But listen, I've been talking to Cy and we agree you should stay with us for a while. At least until you feel better. Come on, just like old times. So we're gonna run into Rose? Don't forget to visit us from Clean Cut to Rose Horrigan. This is a reminder for your upcoming appointment at Clean Cut. Message generated automatically at August 9th, 2076. And then September 2nd, 23rd, November... Yeah, these people are dead. Most recent is January 8th, 2077. Rose Horrigan's journal. What's it say? Respect... my thorta. No, respect my privacy. Sorry, we're not. I think you're dead. And it soars into me like to the parade, my friend. Let's fly. Kiss my forehead, lift me up, touch the sky. After all, we can miss it, can we, little sister? Rosie is BSO thankful. So thankful? My beloved baby sister, bleeping whore, won't understand it. No, you only listen to Julie and echo. Says you have to see the parade in Japantown. Without us, the party burns to the parade. My friend, let's fly. Kiss my forehead. Lift me up to touch the sky. This has to do with the upcoming parade. I will show you how Rosie loves you, you. There. Do you hear the echo? A long time ago, we dropped a pebble from the dam and counted the fall 2-3 echoes, then 4, and then waited for the avalanche 5-6 to cover Night City. And you won't have to go to school. 7, echo, but nothing happened, nothing but horrible silence. It doesn't matter. Have a better idea. We go to the parade, because the dam is already cracking. Okay, so that's from Rose. The one who came to stay with Juliet. And I guess that's the window we crawled out of? On the mini-map there, that smaller exclamation point? I'm hearing a door opening, closing, opening, closing. Right? Too quiet in here. Got me a little spooked. I'm sorry. Jules, please forgive me for how I'm doing this. I'm nowhere near as tough as you, and I can't pretend to be anymore. I hate to say it, but there's no helping Rose anymore, so at least help yourself before it's too late. If you change your mind, I'll be waiting for you at Sunset Motel. Think on it again, please. Always yours, Cy. Alright, so the guy left. Rose was a little too much for him to handle. That save you. I guess her dead body's somewhere around here. Oh, we go down even more. I guess I found out. Test results. Rose Torrigan, test results. HGB. I don't know what the other stuff is. Hemoglobin, maybe? White blood cell? Red blood cell? Comments. PLT and TSH slightly exceeded. No medical consultation is needed. However, regarding the patient's worsening state of mind, psychological consultation is advised. For Rose, the visitor. Painting. Interesting.
No. Interesting.
A safe behind a painting. A little cliche. But hey, at least the Merc appreciates the arts. You could learn a thing or two.
Wondering more how it ended up on the ground.
Think so?
Juliet must have been in a hurry.
Yeah. Something twisted happened here, V.
Got that right. Well, before I mess with the painting, let's just take a look at this. That's that same message about
Rose. I'm starting to like this less and less. Best stay on our toes.
You're right. Ms. Horrigan. Oh, it's from Victor Vector to Juliet. I'm happy you turned to me instead of those clean-cut scam artists. But I am sorry I don't have good news for you. The symptoms you described indicate a serious disorder that will continue to progress regardless of next steps taken. In cases like this, I'm afraid no level of help you give your sister will do much good. The only real cure is one of the two MaxTac ways, if you understand my meaning. It's good you reach out to me, but it's best you contact them next. The quicker they get on this, the safer it'll be for everyone around her, including you. Victor Vector. What's going on with Rose? From Clara Horrigan to Juliet Horrigan. Julie, since yesterday, Rose called me 40 times, but all I ever hear on the line is erratic breathing. And I never get a response when I call her back. You know what's going on? I'm really worried. Love, Mom. From Juliet to Claire. Hey, Mom, everything's all right. You know Rosie. Winky smiley face. When you have 100 implants like she does, chances are at least one's got a chip loose somewhere. Don't worry about it. We've got everything all under control. Smiley face. Love you, Juliet. All okay, urgent. From El Capitan to Juliet. Julia's all okay? Been a while since we talked last, and I got a few jobs that I can't trust anyone else with. Plus, there's the matter of Mr. KT's data. Right back quick. Time ain't on our side on this one. Oh. Look for the chip. There's Rose Horrigan. She has a break hold, a charge jump. Send a Vistan Mark 1. Not sure what that is. Award is only 10 euros. Watching you. Well, we know she's down there. That's the only camera. Can I do anything else with anything down here? A generator. See, I don't know where I'm coming up from. Otherwise, I'd distract her. That's Juliet. Looks pretty dead. Yeah, I don't know where the,
Juliet, why? Why would you do this to me?
Locked.
If life's taught me one thing, it's that a safe's a good spot to hide your valuables.
Got a reader, too.
Yeah.
Must be an access shirt around.
Safe purchased by Juliet Horrigan. Yeah, I'm not looking forward to finding her for some reason. I'm a little spooked out by her.
You do this to me?
Is she coming out? It's down there, right? Okay, here goes nothing.
Friends can't keep me here, they said. Oh, great.
Okay. That wasn't bad. The only problem is if she had anything on her, I don't get to have it, right? No. The save key. Access granted. Illness diary. I want to see the illness diary. Day 67, high temp, migraines, difficulty speaking. Day 68, high temp, migraines, delirious again. Day 69, some improvement. Rosie isn't complaining of pain, she's eating and talking normally again. Maybe the new pills are finally working? Day 71, an attack. Acts like nothing's happened. Sai's arm is broken in two places. Gave her a triple dose, calmed after an hour. Day 72, as always, she doesn't remember a thing. Sai, that saint of a man, lied and said it was a hit and run. She's back to normal, no more pain. She even made us breakfast for us. Christ. Day 80, even though these pills are draining our bank account dry, at least they're doing the job. Just need to maintain a higher dose. Rosie is back to herself, and only once did I think I heard her talking in an empty room. As long as she's not hurting anyone. Day 91, another attack. Had to give her... Four times nine normal dose. Why do I bother? I can't do this anymore. Well. Order confirmation. So you gotta wonder how many different email accounts does she have that each laptop or computer is signed into a different one. From off-med store to Juliet Harrigan, your order has been approved. Please keep this confirmation for your records. Lidocaine, 50 times 10 milligrams, and beta-haloperidol. That must be the psych med, 200 times 0.5 milligrams. Your order will be shipped to the listed address within 5 business days. There is no listed address. Mega Medicine Library. Well. I never closed those. Until now. I wonder how hard that fight would have been if I had just snuck up on her and broke her neck. She was freaking me out a little, so I felt like it would be a good idea. And another 55 around here. Yeah. Well, I'm sorry, Juliet. Anything we can do here? Besides break things? Oh. Now there's an image. Okay, then. All right, let's go open that safe. Whoops. Jesus. A shard and M76E Omaha.
Can't have bad luck all the time.
Family matters. Deposit the data shard in a drop point. I'm like, I thought that was all piled up newspapers. Where's this drop point? Wait, we're here? Okay. Now I wish I had a car. I wonder if it's really a high difficulty to just deposit it. Are there people waiting for me there or something? Whoa. Now, first of all, that was a very wide turn. Oh, wait, this way? Second of all, there is no second of all. They want me to go up there. Yeah, I wish I did bring a car now. Oh. Patrol officers. Yeah, I don't want any problems with them. Hi. Who are these? Beat cop? I need to cross the road anyway. In my experience, you get too close to the police officers, you just start firing on you. Could you imagine if it was like that in real life? They're just like, oh no you don't, and start blam blam blam. Control. Wait, I'm clicking open, I think. I don't wanna. There we go.
What happened to Juliet V?
She's dead.
Fuck. She never mentioned she had a sister.
And a mother.
That's a crying shame. Thanks for grabbing that data, V. Gig's closed. I'll be in touch.
You sure will. Hey, that's a good amount of eddies, over 5,000 there. Sweet. Shall I... maybe we'll finish up with some light reading here. Just a little bit. Pathology of the Badlands. Have you ever dreamed of leaving the city for a life on the road? Has your child ever told you they dream of becoming a nomad adventurer? Mistake. The romanticization of these brave highway pirates is as common as it is harmful. These drifters are not as mysterious or noble as you might think. No. In fact, they are no different from any criminal organization, although even organization may be a stretch. These wandering bands are no more than chaotic jumbles of trigger-happy anarchists roaming just outside the margins of civilization. Descended primarily from the largely extinct agrarian society of the Californias and beyond, these outsiders have rejected the amenities of modernity and chosen instead a path of bloody revolt. They make rusted trucks and trailers their homes, denying themselves the basic necessities of running water and SCSMs. I forgot what that stands for. I used to know it. All of this squalor, by choice. Is this yet proof enough of their insanity? Of course, they do manage to scrape together just enough to survive. How, you ask? Without factories, hotels, restaurants, and bars, they attack us. The transports of weapons and food destined for our businesses and dinner tables. As if not shamed enough already, they smuggle psychoactive drugs across our borders. Even known murderers... and rapists. Murderers? Should be. It's true, and they themselves are known to whore themselves out for contract killings. The bloodiest and most brutal that no one else would dare attempt. You might think that these self-proclaimed rebels, these fighters for a cause, would have some semblance of camaraderie. Nothing could be further from the truth. These scattered gangs of vagabonds and drifters are divided into dozens, if not hundreds, of smaller subgroups who are at each other's throats more often than not. One day they unify to hijack a textile transport, the next they murder each other in cold blood as they sleep. Even their children join in on the bloodbath. While our kids receive games and toys for their birthdays, theirs are given rifles and rusty blades. But don't blame the children. Blame the parents for depriving them of a happy and fulfilling future. And for what? Some illusion of freedom? Obscured by a shroud of resentment and envy? Each of them has the potential to become a future technician, netwatch agent, or even CEO, but instead they'll die alone in the desert, buried under the sand, all for a couple ennies or a pouch of drugs. Still have romantic dreams of the Badlands? I didn't think so. Well, that's one perspective. New release BDs. Phew, that's hot. Volume 3. Return of the Psycho. Piece by Piece. Good song by Slayer. The Executioner's Diary. No Parachute Plummet. Scream Baby Scream and On the Edge. Stop Complaining, Get Rich Today by Josh Kevorkian. The first and most important lesson, you and only you are responsible for your situation in life. Don't wait for the government to take pity on you. Don't wait for your loved ones to lend a helping hand. Just pull yourself up by your bootstraps and get to work. I know what you're going to say. Unemployment is at 34%. But so what? What's stopping you from starting your own business? It's that damn simple. What's that? You say you need an education? So educate yourself, for Christ's sakes. From now on, I don't want to hear any excuses. What matters is that you can be rich too, but you have to want it. And for that, you have to work for it. Okay. Sometimes it's not that easy, dude. And that's it. We're caught up with the readings. Thought I had more. But anyway, we're headed next for this side job. This one's not high. This is moderate. And then this is the finishing up the Welcome to Night City job that we did an episode or two ago as well. And then the Ripper Dock. So, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.